I would say this is like, put yourself in my shoes or the label owner's shoes. If you are running a label that's doing well and releasing music regularly, I just read the directions. And if you know that person, if you know that label and they say like, yo, hit me up on Messenger and that's the directions, that's great. But if they have a form and they have a method, I mean, for me, it's about being organized. So I'll back up as a label. And I wanted to ask you guys these questions. Question one, have any of you guys, or, you know, one by one, let me know if you have released with a label. And then the other question I wanted to ask you guys is what's your experience of sending demos to a label? How has that been for you? So what I got when I first started the label is that what I got was that a lot of people were sending out the demos and getting no response. And that was really hard for some people to process emotionally, because they're making themselves vulnerable and love and emotion into their music. And it's like a very personal experience. And then they're like, all right, this is a moment, I'm going to send it out, and crickets. That sucks. That's disrespectful to you guys. And so as a label, we made the decision from day one that we're going to listen as much as possible to every single demo and give feedback and give them an honest response. No, you're not there right now. You need to work on your sound design. You need to work on your drums. You need to work on your composition. But that doesn't mean stop. That doesn't mean you can't send us again. It's never a flat out rejection, go away. It's like, keep working hard. We're all in this together. This is fun. I really want to create that community of like, when you see somebody and they like electronic music, it's kind of like a nod. It's like, yo, I see you. You're in the future. Like, you want to, you know, do this. So, you know, a little pie in the sky, but we absolutely listen to every demo and we give feedback. So that's something that I think a lot of labels either are not set up to do, or they just don't want to put in the money because I'm paying somebody to listen to it, or time to do it. And so I don't know. I think we're different in that regard. So to kind of circle back is, if you know me, me and you are friends and we've met, or we've, you know, interacted enough on the internet, then yeah, maybe a Facebook Messenger is good. But the thing is like, and I hate to say this, I have 5,000 friends on Facebook, and it wasn't by design. I didn't go out and add everybody. I've just been on there and in the music scene for enough that I kind of hit that. And so I really do get too much stuff coming through that channel. And so my commitment to artists is that we do our best to listen to every demo. So I want you guys, whoever, to go through the proper channel so that we can be organized. We use Label Engine. Everything comes in and it's like waiting in a queue, and it's either new or held or signed or rejected. I have someone else do a first pass or listening for like, does this have the potential for this to make sense for Gravitas? Some people are sending us techno. We don't release techno. Some people are sending us rock music. Like, that's just no, like, didn't read the directions. You didn't study the label. So that would be the first thing, is like, I would go and find 2 to 3 labels that make sense for your music. Not only but for your music, but for where you are in your career. Jerry said that you released on Play Me. Like, they're a big label. But Reed is really smart, because she knows same kind of thing of what we're trying to do with Gravitas Create. You've got your sort of established artists. They have their fans. They have their following. And then Play Me Too is sort of their up and coming brand, and they have sort of different channels, different socials for that. So, I mean, that can be a lot to sort of understand from the outside, but I would say match your profile, match your career with a label that's sort of in that same bracket of where you are. Or maybe, hey, maybe your music is so fire that you're going to release on Monster Cat on day one, you know, or whatever. So, all of this is just my suggestions. There's no hard and fast rules, but I think respect people's time, understand where they're coming from as a business, as a entrepreneur, as someone that's probably getting a lot of things coming their way. And I mean, straight up, I own 4 businesses, so it's information overload. Like, I'm doing my best just to keep up. Short answer, read the directions, you know, use their system, and that will be, hopefully, you know, kind of earn points. If you don't read the directions from me, that means like you're not paying attention and you're not taking it seriously.